Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about translators. So for this video, you will be learning on the need for assembler software for the translation of an assembly language program, a compiler for the translation of a high-level language program, as well as an interpreter for the translation and execution of a high-level programming language. First of all, let's look at translator. So, instructions in a program can only be executed when written in machine code and loaded into the main memory of a computer. I hope you can recall what machine code is from chapter 4. And next, programming instructions written in any program language other than machine code must be translated before they can be used. So you can think of translator just like a language translator that we use. For example, we use the language translator to translate French to English, Japanese to English, and etc. So for this translator, in computer science perspective, you are just translating, for example, assembly language or high-level language into machine code so that the computer can understand the machine code and execute the instructions. So let's look at different types of translators. So first of all, we have assemblers, which translate assembly language into machine code. And next will be compilers. So compiler translate high-level language into machine code. And lastly, we also have interpreters which translate high-level language into machine code. So these are the three types of translators. So some of you might be asking, what's the difference between assembly language and high-level language? So you can think of it this way. Assembly language is like a language that the computer can understand and you don't really understand. And high-level language is a language that maybe you and your friends can understand easily. Now let's look at assembler. So definitely we have covered assembler in chapter 4, and now we are just doing a quick recap. So first of all, in order for a program written in assembly language to be executed, it needs to be translated into machine code using an assembler which translates each assembly language instruction into a machine code instruction, checks syntax of the assembly language, as well as speeds up development time as errors are identified before program is executed. So as I say, basically assembler just converts or translates assembly language into machine code. Then we have two types of assembler. The first one will be single pass assembler, which converts mnemonic source code into machine code and put the machine code instructions straight into the computer memory to be executed. And next will be two-pass assembler. So for some of you who forget what two-pass assembler is, you can refer back to my videos in chapter 4. So before we dive into compiler and interpreter, let's look at the layman explanation between both of them. So imagine you have a cake recipe that you want to make, but it's written in ancient Greek and you do not know ancient Greek. So there are two ways that you can do. So the first method is someone translate the recipe into English version for you, and you could read the English version of the recipe to make the cake. So think of this translated recipe as the compiled version. And the second way is, if you have a friend who knows ancient Greek, when you're ready to make the cake, your friend will be sitting next to you and translate the recipe into English as you go line by line. So in this case, your friend is the interpreter for the interpreter version of the recipe. So always think of this example when you forget the difference between compiler and interpreter. So how does a compiler work? So first of all, compiler program and source code file are made available, but no data is needed. And then compiler programs begins execution. First line of the source code is read. The line is then analyzed. If an error is found, this is recorded. If no error is found, the line of source code is converted to an intermediate code. The next line of source code is read and steps 4 to 7 are repeated. So basically, you just keep reading the source code line by line and check for error. And next, when the whole of the source code has been dealt with, one of the following happens. So the first one will be, if no error is found in the whole source code, the complete intermediate code is converted into object code, which is an executable file. And if any errors are found, a list of this is output and no object code is produced. So in a nutshell, just remember that compiler attempt to translate the whole source code into an executable file. If there is an error, a separate error report is created. So the whole idea of compiler is translate the whole source code into executable file. And if there's error, no executable file and produce error report. Now let's look at a sample compilation process. So first of all, we have source program, and then we have text editor, and then we have this myprogram.vb, means that you're writing this program in Visual Basic form. And then we have Visual Basic compiler. And if no error, we will produce myprogram.exe. And let's say we have error, we'll just produce this error report. And then we'll just try to fix the source program. And now let's look at how does an interpreter work. So first of all, the interpreter program, the source code file, and the data to be used by the source code program are all made available. And then the interpreter program begins execution. Next will be the first line of the source code is read. And then the line is analyzed. If an error is found, this is reported. And the interpreter program halts execution. It means that as soon as an error is found, the interpreter program will stop. If no error is found, the line of source code is converted to an intermediate code. The interpreter program uses this intermediate code to execute the required action. And then finally, the next line of source code is read and steps 4 to 8 are repeated. So in a nutshell, just remember that interpreter reads each line, then translate it and execute it. It will stop when an error is encountered. And lastly, let's do a summary, which is the difference between assembler, compiler, and interpreter. So first of all, source program is written in assembly language for assembler, high level language for both compiler and interpreter. And next will be machine dependent. So does assembler depend on machine? Yes. Compiler? No. Interpreter? No. And next, is object program generated? Yes, for assembler, it's stored on disk or in main memory. Same for compiler. For interpreter, it's a no. Instructions are executed under the control of the interpreter. And finally, each line of the source program generates one machine code instruction, which is one-to-one translation for assembler. And for compiler and interpreter, many machine code instructions, which is a instruction explosion. And lastly, let's look at one passive question. So first of all, what are usually used when a high-level language program is complete? They translate all the code at the same time and then run the program. Next will be, they produce something, files that can be run without the source code, something translate one line of a high-level language program at a time and then run that line of code. They are most useful while developing the programs because errors can be corrected and then the program continues from that line. And finally will be, assemblers are used to translate assembly code into something. So just try to get an answer from the video and comment down below. Thank you, and I'll see you again then. Bye bye.